tonight on SciEyes on the Skies.
We've had bitter cold temperatures with dangerous wind chills over the weekend. We'll show you when we start to warm up and when we'll see 30s in the forecast.
Plus, Trey has our national forecast. SciEyes on the Skies starts now.
Live from Studio 171 in Ames, Iowa, the Iowa State Meteorology Department team of meteorologists brings you the latest weather from around the country and out your front door. Iowa State's longest-running television program and the only live weather broadcast on campus starts right now. This is SciEyes on the Skies.
Good evening, and welcome to SciEyes on the Skies. I'm Hunter Faust. It's time for this day in weather history. Just like how frigid it's been outside recently, I do have some good news. On this date back in 1936, Iowa was experiencing an intense cold similar to what we've already been experiencing and having to endure. But luckily for us, we've had it much nicer. Back in 1936, two-thirds of the state of Iowa was reporting temperatures well below zero, as well as many stations reporting extremely cold temperatures. Some of those temperatures reached even minus 28 degrees. And even an incredible minus 33 degrees Fahrenheit. Lucky for us, we didn't get nearly as cold. We look forward to some warmth coming our way in the coming days as Arctic air begins to move out. Up next, Trey is going to be giving our national forecast.
Welcome back to SciEyes on the Skies. We're going to take a look now at your national forecast. And first, let's begin with a look at the temperatures right now across the nation. We're going to go region by region here, starting off in the upper Midwest, where we've had a very cold weather pattern in place for the last several days. You can see temperatures are still very cold at this hour, with single digits here west of the Mississippi River. And then once you get east of the Mississippi, still a little bit cold as you get into the Great Lakes region. Now, as we move farther to the east here and take a look at our temperatures across the Northeast, things are faring a little bit better. You haven't really been in the brunt of that cold weather just yet for areas along the I-95 corridor, but it is slowly working its way in to the interior regions. This is what I believe is most impressive here. As we get down to the deep south here, a bone-chilling cold air mass in place from Oklahoma and Texas all the way east into Tennessee. We've got temperatures into the teens this evening. We've had record-breaking cold this morning and a lot of snowfall as well with this pattern that we've seen over the last several days. And then as we get into the desert southwest here, you kind of escape the cold here, a little bit warmer as you get down into the desert regions of Arizona and California, and then colder as you move inland. And then across the Pacific Northwest this evening, you can see temperatures pretty much remaining standard here, cool as you get over to the west coast, and then as you move interior into the Rockies, temperatures in the teens and 20s this evening. Here's a look at the water vapor imagery here. We've got a very active pattern that has been responsible for a lot of the cold weather that we've seen and a lot of winter storm activity. Big upper level trough in place across the CONUS this evening. We've got one storm system ejecting off the East Coast. That was Sunday's storm system that brought bone chilling cold and a lot of big issues down to the south. And then we're looking at another one right on its heels this evening, moving into the southern plains states. And you can see that one is definitely causing a lot of issues in terms of our watches and warnings. First, we want to look at the upper Midwest, where we still have a couple wind chill advisories, basically for dangerously cold wind chills in place. And then as we move down to the south, look at the winter storm warnings that we have in place this evening. Once again, Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, and Tennessee are all hot spots. And some of these locations, again, were just hit on Sunday with a major winter storm. Look at the ice storm warnings there as well. This could be a crippling ice storm event for portions of East Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi as we get into the day tomorrow. So speaking of the day tomorrow, these are the winter weather threats with this upcoming storm. High potential for heavy snowfall across portions of North Texas into Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Tennessee. Now, things get very tricky here once you get in between the I-10 and the I-20 corridors. This is where we could see quite a bit of freezing rain, so a high potential there. Cold temperatures remain an issue as well, as we have thousands and millions of people that are still without power from Sunday's storm. So definitely a lot of issues going on across the deep south this evening. As we take a look at the satellite and radar picture, you can see we are already looking at our next storm system moving into the southern plains this evening. Widespread snow breaking out with that across North Texas and central Oklahoma. You can see as we put it into motion here on FutureCast, over the next 12 hours, we're going to watch that system really get organized, begin to pick up more Gulf of Mexico moisture with snow, sleet, and freezing rain across portions of the deep south. That system continues to move off to the east as we get into the day tomorrow, quickly ejecting up the east coast as we get into Thursday. But notice behind the system, really not much going on across the central U.S. and into the Midwest states. So that will give folks some time to dry out and warm up after this big storm system. You can see the upper atmosphere over the next several days. Once we get this system on out of here, I do believe we are going to see a much better pattern approach as we get into the weekend, a more zonal flow that will allow for some milder air to approach its way in from the Pacific. And that is certainly some things we could use for areas that have been hit hard. A look at the week plus one outlook here. This is for Nashville, Tennessee. You can clearly see the next couple days look pretty dicey here, but as we get into the weekend, we will warm back up above freezing, should see substantial melting take place, and then look at next Tuesday, a high of 58 degrees.
Now, here's our weather question for the day. What was the snowiest year on record at Des Moines, Iowa? A, 1926 to 1927. B, 1986 to 1987. C, 1911 to 1912, or D, 2002 to 2003. We'll have that answer coming up, but first, here's your Iowa forecast with Lucas.
Welcome back to Size Eyes on the Skies, and I'm here with your Iowa forecast. Now let's look at the current conditions out there. We got a temperature right around 2 degrees, with winds out of the west-southwest at 8 miles an hour. That's causing a wind chill right now of minus 12 degrees. As we take a look at the temperatures around the state, we got temperatures right around 0 degrees through much of the state. As we move up to the northeast part of the state near Decorah, we can potentially see double digits up there, which is something we have not seen in quite a while. As we take a look at the weather headlines for this week, we can finally say goodbye to the Arctic air. We got snow chances coming up this weekend and close to 40 early next week. As we look at the radar out there, we got nothing going on as far as precipitation for our region. As we look over to Nebraska, we got some cloud cover moving into western Iowa, and that's going to overtake us overnight tonight and into tomorrow, and that's going to stick with us for quite a while. Now let's take a look at that in our future cast, as we got snow chances moving up into Missouri, but with the dry air sitting over Iowa and Minnesota currently, that's got no chance of making it up into our area, as that's just going to breeze on by through Illinois over to Chicago. As we move through tomorrow, into tomorrow evening, we got that cloud cover sticking around. And the same thing overnight and into Thursday and Thursday evening. We just have some clouds staying around for our neck of the woods, and they start to move out and start to dissipate as we get towards Thursday evening. As we take a look at the 7-day forecast, we got the teens sticking around for the rest of this work week. And we get into the weekend, we start to see temperatures more towards normal for this time of year. We got a snow chance coming up on Sunday with some minor accumulations right now, but it's something to keep an eye on as you get closer to the weekend. If you're traveling this weekend, keep that in mind and just watch the forecast. And as you can see, on Monday and Tuesday, we got temperatures near 40 with upper 30s as highs. That's going to feel a lot warmer than it was the last couple of days. As we take a look at the hourly temperatures for tomorrow, as you can see, we'll wake up at minus 4. This is still quite chilly, so still bundle up tomorrow morning and throughout the day. As you can see, our forecast high is still 23 degrees below average for this time of year. We'll send you back to Hunter for the end of this edition.
Thank you for that, Lucas. Let's review our weather question of the day. What was the snowiest year on record at Des Moines, Iowa? A, 1926 to 1927. B, 1986 to 1987. C, 1911 to 1912. Or D, 2002 to 2003. The correct answer is 1911 to 1912, where Des Moines, Iowa received a massive total of 72 inches of snowfall that season. That's all for this edition. Thank you for joining us for Size Eyes on the Skies. Please be sure to check us out on Facebook and Twitter, and join us here again next week. Thank you, and have a good night.